I'll just quote from the further education strategy. New community members in Ireland come from a wide range of cultural, linguistic, educational, social backgrounds. They may be highly educated with professional and skilled backgrounds who are attending ESOL classes to learn English or to improve their English. Okay. This cohort are actually reflected in the adults that are coming forward for ESOL classes in our ETB. The profile of ESOL learner in adult ed is age 35 to 44, unemployed more than a year. A third of the students coming forward, reflecting the statistics that Sandra gave earlier, a third of them have upper second level or FETAC 4 or 5. A further third have FETAC level 6 qualifications, probably from their own countries coming in. Well, they would have, and they are on courses for 1 to 2 years to improve their English. And the majority have remained at the current level, okay, after a year or two. This cohort of adults are obviously languishing in ESOL classes, and they're not progressing. We are all under pressures from the Department of Social Protection to activate learners and to move them forward. If students are presenting with qualifications at FETAC level 5 and level 6, they obviously are capable of entering the workforce. Okay, they're at a level where they can engage with work. They don't have literacy issues. Therefore, the issue we have is how to move them forward. I talked to the principals in our colleges of further education, and the issues they have are, it's very difficult for them to identify students who will cope with the subject content of the courses at level 5 and level 6 when they're mixed in with native English speakers. I gave a presentation to the principals from our colleges of further education, and also to some of our secondary schools also do adult education courses at level 5 and 6. The tool we're using is the Cambridge Placement Test. It's an online interactive exam, and it assesses students' reading and listening skills. When you say to an ESOL student, you test them and you say your level isn't good enough to get into a college of further education or to get into a higher education, that's not a permanent exclusion. That means currently, as it stands, go back, come back next year. Okay, so in that year that they're told to go back and upskill in their reading, writing, speaking and listening, they could be passed back to adult ed, or they could do fee-paying evening courses, or sometimes IT Tal in particular run language courses in the evenings for adults who are trying to get onto their courses.
And next question, what are the issues relating to the uptake of ESOL learners onto higher ed courses?
For ESOL learners, for example, trying to get into Trinity, UCD, it's IELTS 6 or 6.5. That's a very high language level. If you've been living here, native English speakers don't get to that level. C1 in proficiency. You don't get to that level. A lot of people don't. So the bar is very, very high, and there's very little support and funding to get students up to this level. Higher ed, the bar is much, much higher. With further ed, I've talked to our principals. When they test, they have information of a student's level in listening and reading and grammar because of the placement test that we can facilitate for them. They have the information that this student is a B1. If the course that they're running is of a practical nature, they will be perfectly happy accepting B1. If it's a more academic course, then they're mixing in with native English speakers, and there's no accommodation from the trainer who's giving the class for language levels or language needs in the class, then they would prefer the students would have a B2. It's all based on interview, and it's much more fluid. But they have the information and they can make a decision, so that maybe 2 months into the course they don't suddenly realise this student isn't achieving. It's taken up a place on a course that maybe he would be better off taking the following year. I've talked to lecturers, and I went to IT Tal in preparation for this, and I talked to lecturers. They're correcting work from a cohort of students. They're going through the corrections. They come up against a student who they see is an ESOL student. From the types of grammatical mistakes that they're making, they get exasperated, put it to the bottom and correct, and then come up against this student again. It's very difficult when you're correcting 80, 100 scripts, when you have the levels of grammatical error that occur, you know, in higher education. The difficulty is further education and FETAC level five. Five and four should all benchmark against the common European framework so students are able to progress.
Back to just an earlier point I'm making, if we wanted to take run a core, a programme at level three, are we looking then for the level of entry for an ESOL learner to be at an ESOL kind of level four to get on a level three programme that isn't English language necessarily, or maybe English language is a part of it, but to be able for the other modules, they have to be coming in with a higher level of English as an entry point?
They need more support at level three and level four. Four is probably, once they've done ESOL level four, they can move sideways or onwards. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. I don't think FETAC level three ESOL students should be moving in, but then they don't have the skills. It's way too low.
If we do move to more kind of intensive programmes, from an adult literacy perspective, so the worry is that we're maybe moving away from the very learner-centred approach to tuition, which is something that is inherent in a literacy service, and ESOL learners benefit from that because it's all about integration and empowerment. And that is probably, I would see as my worry as an educator, that if we move to very structured, you know, you're in this program, it's 8 weeks and we're going to get you from here to, is there a fear that we won't touch into that kind of learner-centered approach?
I'm talking about the higher levels, if they're on the cusp of employment, but English is a barrier, they need to be assisted with their English language development and courses need to be provided at the upper levels. How frustrating it is for a student who has a level six qualification from their own country, who is in a class that's taking 120 hours, their need and their internal need to progress. You need to look at if you're talking about learner-centeredness, you need to look at the learner at the, I'm talking about the higher levels, and I'll reiterate that again, how frustrating it is for you not to be able to be in employment, full-time employment, and transfer your skills from your level six qualification to employment here or onto a further ed course.
I'm talking only
about the upper echelons, the ones who are on the cusp of employment, they have already level five, level six qualifications from their own country. They need to be assisted. If you're looking at learner-centeredness focuses on the learner themselves, and a student in that position is in a cycle of poverty. They're trapped in not being able to get employment because they can't prove their language level.